Olá, pessoal. Hello, everyone. I hope you can hear me and see me. Let me just check. Okay. Tell me here in the chat. Can you hear me? Can you see me? Everything all right? I hope so. So let's get started with today's live class. Once again, hello, everyone. Olá, pessoal. Welcome to this live Portuguese class. I'm very excited to have you all here today, Aura, and I help you to become fluent in Portuguese, even from zero, with Brazilian music. And today, I'm going to teach you some Christian vocabulary and culture with the song Resucitou, a Portuguese version of the song Resurrecting by the Elevation Worship Group. Have you heard of this before? So today we're gonna go through that Brazilian version of the song, okay? But before we get started, if you're new here, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of my future videos. Also, follow me on other social media too. I'm there by Sing Brazilian and I upload new videos every week, okay? Great! Let's see if we have any messages here until now. So if you have anything, you can tell me in the comments. Olá, Norman! Norman is saying hi to us here. Olá! Okay, anyone else? Tell me here in the comments, okay? Great! So, like I said, we're gonna be using this class today, and I decided to bring this topic here because Easter is coming, you know? I saw it as a good opportunity to talk about this, to learn some Christian and Easter vocabulary for those who are interested in that, okay, in Portuguese. So, today, here in Brazil, is Good Friday. We call it Sexta-feira Santa. So the Good Friday, the holiday Good Friday in Portuguese is Sexta-feira Santa, okay? It's a little bit different. It's like we're saying Holy Friday, you know? Santa is holy. So, and Friday is Sexta-feira. And in 2 days from now, we have Easter, that is Páscoa in Portuguese. Páscoa, okay? So, Páscoa is an important holiday for Christians, you know. It marks the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Jesus Cristo, like we say in Portuguese, okay? Jesus Cristo. So it's not only about chocolate Easter eggs that we call ovos de Páscoa. So Easter eggs are ovos de Páscoa, okay? Or you can say chocolate eggs, so ovos de chocolate. So Easter is not only about that, okay? It's much deeper than that. Also, it's not about the Easter bunny. Do you know what is Easter bunny in Portuguese? It's coelhinho da Páscoa. So a way to say bunny in Portuguese is putting the diminutive, coelhinho da Páscoa. So it's not only about that too. It's about Jesus. It's about Jesus, like we say here in Portuguese. Okay? And the song I chose for this is the Brazilian version of the Resurrecting by Elevation Worship. Okay? I don't know if you know this song in English, okay? But in Portuguese, it was recorded by the group Kemuel. It's a Christian group here. We also call it Christian music, so música cristã or música gospel. So this musical style here has these two different names. They mean the same, okay? So you can see as música cristã or música gospel, okay? So, very good. Let's start here by listening to a part of this song together, okay? I'm gonna share here with you my screen. And we're gonna be listening to a part of this song together, okay? All right, so I'm gonna play the song now. Let's listen to it.
mas hoje em glória está o Salvador, lavou meus pés e hoje aos seus pés estou. Nosso pecado cai.
Okay, so instead of listening to the whole song and after that going through the vocabulary, let's go part by part, okay? So we already listened to the first part of the song, now we're gonna go through the vocabulary of this first part, alright? So starting here, just open this part here. Alright, so starting here. Coberto com espinhos foi. Coberto com espinhos foi. This means like coberto is covered with, covered with thorns. So espinhos are thorns. Okay, let's write this down. So espinhos. Espinhos, thorns. So Jesus used this thorn, this crown made of thorns. So we call it coroa de espinhos, this thorn crown. Okay, coroa de espinhos. That's what they're saying here. So he was covered with thorns. Coberto com espinhos foi, was. Mas hoje em glória está. Mas hoje em glória está. But today in glory he is. In glory. So, glória is glory. This is easy, right? It sounds the same. So, glory is glória. This vocabulary here can be also very useful if you want to visit a church here in Brazil, you know. So some of these words are used in church in this religious context, okay? It's interesting that you know these words here. So, glória is glory.
O Salvador lavou meus pés. O Salvador lavou meus pés. O Salvador.
Do you know what this means? The Savior. Okay, the Savior. So this is one adjective we usually refer to Jesus as. The Savior. So, Salvador. Salvador. It's also the name of a city in Brazil, in Bahia. So, Salvador. Okay, it's because of this religious meaning. Lavou meus pés, washed my feet, okay, making a reference to when Jesus washed the disciples' feet, okay, lavou os pés.
E hoje aos seus pés estou, and today I am by his feet,
no, by his feet I am, okay? Next part now. We're gonna listen to the next part of the song now. Let me play for you.
Nosso pecado carregou com majestoso.
So the second part here now.
Nosso pecado carregou. Nosso pecado.
This is another word that is important in this context here. So pecado is sin. Sin. So when we say
Nosso pecado, our sin. Carregou.
So our sin he carried, he bore.
Carregou.
So save this word here. Pecado e sin.
Quão majestoso és.
How majestic you are.
This kind of gender here is interesting in Portuguese because it's one of the contexts where we actually use a more formal and old language.
So in the, for example, in the religious environment, in the Bible, you're going to be seeing people in some languages of the Bible, because there are different versions. So in some versions, you're going to see the use of like the conjugation for verbs that we do not use in conversations, you know, in day to day, we do not use those verbs. But since it's something old, you know, comes from an old culture, you will see it in Bible and you will still see it in some songs. So, for example, I always tell you, we tend not to use the tu and the vós conjugated. So these are people, these are personal pronouns in Portuguese that we tend not to use conjugated correctly because it's very formal. But in this religious meaning, sometimes you see it. For example, here this word quão, this is like how much, how majestic here. Quão majestoso. This is a word that we do not use in other contexts, you know. It's something very specific, it's something very formal and even old, this quão here. And the conjugation, see, majestoso es. This is the conjugation for the tu, for the personal pronoun tu. Tu es, okay? I always tell you, in real life, we do not say tu es legal, you are cool. No, we say tu é legal, tu é, okay? So we conjugate it in the wrong way. But it's the way we use in real life, okay? But in this context here, you will see everything conjugated correctly, okay? Moving on. So, majestoso, let's put here this one too. Majestoso is majestic.
Teu amor perfeito brilhará. Teu amor perfeito brilhará.
Your perfect love will shine.
Brilhará.
See, here we're also using another verbal tense that in everyday conversation we tend not to use. That is the futuro do presente. So, a more common way to say this would be teu amor perfeito vai brilhar, will shine. This is futuro imediato. We use it much more often in Portuguese. You can find videos about it here in my channel already, okay? But here they're using futuro do presente, brilhará. You put the future already conjugated in the verb, okay? Moving on.
E todos hão de ver.
This here too. E todos hão de ver. This is a form of the verb haver. Haver is a verb that can be similar to exist, you know? So, the translation to this would be and everyone will see.
Todos hão de ver.
But there are simpler ways to say this. You know, a simpler way to say would be e todos vão ver. And everybody will see. But this hão de ver here is very formal and even old. Another thing you find in this context here. In music, in songs, in the Bible, you will see this ão. So, ão comes from the verb haver, that is similar to exist, okay? But not in this meaning. Here is just to say in the future, okay? Okay, very good. Let's move on to the next part, and for that, we're gonna listen to the next part together, okay? Let me put here.
You know me, Deus, if they say don't. Alright, so the next part here is the chorus of the song, o refrão, and it says Teu nome, Deus, é vencedor. So, teu nome, your name. Teu nome, your name. Teu nome, Deus. See how we pronounce the word. Deus is not Deus. Okay, it's not Deus. Deus is in Spanish. In Portuguese, it's Deus. Repeat after me. Deus. And this means God. Okay, God. So, teu nome, Deus. Your name, God. É vencedor. You are the winner. So, your name is victorious. Your name is winner. Vencedor. Let's put as victorious here. Vencedor. Victorious. A Cristo Rei todo louvor. A Cristo, to Christ. So this A here is not an article, okay? It's a preposition. Because Cristo is a masculine word. So Cristo is o Cristo. But here this A is a preposition. This means to Christ. A Cristo, okay? A Cristo Rei, to the Christ, King. So, Rei is King. Todo o louvor, all the praise. So, louvor is praise, okay? This is also important vocabulary in this context. So, louvor is praise. And since we're talking about Cristo, here, you might know that in Brazil, in Rio, in Rio de Janeiro, we have a very famous sculpture that is the Cristo Redentor, the Christ the Redeemer. So we call it Cristo Redentor. It's the same meaning as here, so Christ. Very good. Let's go to the next part. Alright, so now they say like this. Let me open here. Não tenho mais o que temer. Não tenho mais o que temer. I have nothing more to fear. So, temer is to fear. Não tenho mais. I have nothing more. O que temer? What to fear? So, temer is the verb to fear. Okay? The word fear is medo. So, medo is something you have. Eu tenho medo. And the verb is temer, to fear something. Okay? Eu tenho paz em ti. I have peace in you. So, paz is peace. I have peace in you. Next part here. Jesus morreu naquela cruz. Jesus morreu. Jesus died. So, the verb here is morrer, to die. Morreu. In the past, morreu, died. Naquela cruz, in that cross. So, cruz, okay? para salvar a mim, to save me. So this is another important verb in this context. Salvar, to save. So, Jesus morreu para salvar a mim. Jesus died to save me. Then they repeat the chorus here, but we're gonna go to the next part, okay? To the next part now, to the second chorus, I would say.
Jesus ressuscitou e vivo está em mim. Em teu nome vivo estou, a vitória tenho em ti. Jesus ressuscitou e vivo está em mim.
Now here they repeat these many times, okay? I'm gonna pause here so we can go through the lyrics. So, next part here. Pelo Espírito de Deus. Pelo Espírito de Deus. So, Espírito. Espírito is a spirit, okay? Spirit. So, Espírito. Espírito de Deus. God's Spirit. But what if I want to say Holy Spirit? How do I say that? We say Espírito, Espírito Santo, Holy Spirit, okay? So, Holy Spirit, Espírito Santo. Here, pelo Espírito de Deus, for God's Spirit, by God's Spirit, vou das cinzas ressurgir. I will resurrect, I will resurge by the ashes, from the ashes. So, cinzas is ashes, okay? So, vou das cinzas ressurgir, I will rise from the ashes, okay? Cinzas, let's put this one here too. Cinzas are ashes.
Jesus ressuscitou e vivo está em mim.
Jesus ressuscitou. Jesus resurrected. Jesus has resurrected. Okay, Jesus rose. Let's put like this. Jesus rose. Ressuscitou. That's how we say it, okay? So, ressuscitou. Jesus rose. E vivo está em mim. And he is alive in me. Okay? He's alive in me. Next part.
Em teu nome vivo estou, a vitória tenho em ti.
Em teu nome, in your name, vivo estou. I am alive. Vivo estou. A vitória tenho em ti. The victory I have in you. So, vitória is victory. This is a name, okay? It's a person's name too. Vitória. Vitória is a feminine name, okay? Vitória. So, they repeat. Jesus ressuscitou e vivo está em mim. Let's go to the next part. This is a very long song. I hope you're still here with me. But we're gonna finish it. We still have some stuff to learn. So, let's go to the next part.
See you.
So now they repeat some parts, okay? Let's just see the ones we haven't seen yet. So first here, we saw this part here. Onde estaria sem ti? This is a question, okay? Where would I be without you? So this is estaria, would be, okay? Estaria, would be. Let's put it like this. Onde estaria, but it's conjugated for eu, okay? Onde eu estaria? Where would I be? Let's put here. Sem ti, without you, God. So, ti is a pronoun we have to use after prepositions, after verbs, okay? And it refers to tu, that is similar to você, and they both mean you in Portuguese, okay? So when I say ti, I'm referring to you. Sem ti, without you. Não seria nada, não. I wouldn't be anything. No, I wouldn't be anything, okay? Não seria nada, não. And the next part here that is also related a lot to the Easter is... Here. A tumba que o abrigou vazia agora está. A tumba que o abrigou. The tomb that housed him. So, tumba is a tomb. Okay? Let's put here. Tumba is a tomb. So, the tomb that housed him. Abrigou, housed. Vazia agora está. Empty now it is. Empty. Vazia. Empty. Seu corpo não está mais lá. His body is not there anymore. Não está mais lá. There. A morte ele venceu. A morte ele venceu. He conquered death. The verb here is vencer. Okay? Vencer can mean to win in Portuguese. To win, okay? To have the victory or something. But in this case, it's to conquer. Okay? So it can also be to conquer. In this case, it is that. So a morte ele venceu. He conquered the death. Okay? He conquered the death. And then they repeat. So, teu nome, Deus é vencedor. Your name, God, is victorious. A Cristo rei todo louvor. To Christ the King, all the praise. Louvor, praise. Okay? Then they will repeat everything here. And that was our song, Ressuscitou. The Brazilian version of Resurrected, Resurrecting. Okay? Let me go back here to full screen now. Okay. So, that's it. That's our song for today. I want to know now if you have questions about this. So, tell me here in the chat if you have any questions, anything I can help with. Now is the time. You can tell me now here in the comments, okay? Anything, guys? You can tell me now. Alright, I guess we have no questions then. Muito bem. So, like I said, we will have Easter in 2 days. We have Páscoa daqui 2 dias, 2 days. And I want to wish you a happy Easter. Feliz Páscoa. Okay, Feliz Páscoa to all of you, alright? And as I said, I hope you enjoyed this lesson, especially if you're looking for some Christian vocabulary, okay? And if you're not, this was still useful, this is still useful for you, because you learned that how to use these different verbal tenses that we don't usually use in conversations, okay? But they appear in these kind of situations. And also, if you want to visit Brazil and you want to go to church or something like that, if you want to know this kind of vocabulary, these kind of songs are very useful for that too, okay? So, let me know here in the comments if this helped you. And also, once again, if you found this lesson helpful, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up, okay? This helps me a lot so more people can see my video. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of my future videos that I upload every week, okay? Every week we have lessons here. And that's it, guys. So, ciao, ciao. Feliz Páscoa. Happy Easter for all of you. Feliz Páscoa para todos vocês. Ciao.